everyone, a very warm welcome to Erisha Edu Support. And today we will discuss about a very interesting topic in which most of the students nowadays they are interested, and I'm getting a lot of inquiries related to test AS. Right now, what is this test AS is all about? Who should take it? Why they should take it? All these things we will discuss in this particular video. And we'll try to give you series of videos related to test AS so that all your doubts could be cleared by us, right? So once again, a very warm welcome to Erisha Edu Support. Now, test AS is what? It's an exam. It's a standardized test which is there to get admission into German universities. Now, the next question which most of the students they ask us is like, for whom this test AS is? Is it for undergrad student or for postgrad student? So remember, my dear children, if you are applying for undergrad from Germany, that is after your 12th, if you want to complete your graduation in German universities, in that case only you need your test AS score, right? Now, all those students who have completed their graduation over here in India and now you want to go to Germany for your post graduation, for you test AS is not needed. It is only needed for undergrad students, that is after 12th, if you want to go and complete your graduation over there at Germany. Now, the next thing is, what is most important over here is, students, they think that since they have completed their 12th, immediately after completing their 12th, they can go and study in Germany. No, there are, see, here in India, to get admission in any university for your undergrad, you just have to complete your 12th, right? But in Germany, they need 13 years of education. That is, after 12th, you need to study one more year, either in India or in Germany. Now, what you can do is, you can study one more year in India in the same field in which you want to take your graduation. Suppose you want to take graduation in terms of computer science engineering or something in economics or humanities. So you complete one more year of study in college in that particular stream itself, and along with that you can prepare for your test AS exam, right? So that's very important. If you don't want to study in India for next one more year and you feel okay, fine, after 12 straight away I want to go to Germany, in that case there is one more pathway is there, that's called student colleague, in which what they will do, they will make you for one full year, they'll make you study German language and some concepts related to the subject in which you are going to pursue your degree over there. So that, I hope that's clear now. I always advise 1 year over here, prepare for your test AS and then go there. It's always beneficial. It removes a lot of confusion and the problems which you may face later on over there. Another thing is, there are two types of universities. There are private universities and public universities. In public university, tuition fees is free. Not everything, just the tuition fees is free. Whereas in private universities, you need to pay your tuition fees also. However, no matter whether it is a public university or a private university, the cost of education in Germany is comparatively lower as compared to other foreign destinations like UK, US, Australia, etc. So that's the reasons this is most preferred destination right now for study abroad. Now, if you talk about top 300 universities also, right, out of them 35, like no, out of top 300 universities, 35 universities are there in Germany itself. So that's again very like what you can say, tempting factor because of which you should like to study in Germany. Now, if you are staying in Germany and you need to study there, and you need to say, obviously you'll do part-time job also over there, after study also they allow you to stay back over there and they allow you to work also. Now, when you study, work as well as stay in a country which is totally using a totally different language, so definitely you should know that language also. So you must learn German also, German language, A1, A2 till B1 level. You should cover your German language course also over here, so that at least your survival over there becomes very easy. It will be easy for you to communicate over there with your people who are surrounding you. To well, you go to work also, you need to communicate with people in German language, so it will become pretty easy and simple for you to. Your life will become easy over there, right? Now let's come back to test AS. Now test AS is 5 hours long test. Yes, 5 hours long test, right? Now it's divided into two parts and it's given in three languages. Either you can take test AS in English or German language, and in certain countries you can even take it in Arabic language. Now in India you have two options, you can say like German language or English language. I suggest my students to take this test AS exam in English language because it's easy for you to understand the questions, and once you understand the concept, if you understand what exactly the question is asking you to do, then your chances of scoring higher in that particular test increases, right? So always try to take the test in English language itself. Now first we will discuss about the core test. It has got, as I told you, 5 hours long test, and it has got two parts, a core test and a subject specific test. Core test is same for everybody irrespective of the subject in which you are going to take up your undergrad. Core test remains same for everyone. So now this core test is of 110 minutes. Now these 110 minutes is further divided into four subtests. In all these four subtests, the number of questions remain same. 22 questions each subject will get. However, the time which they allot you to solve those 22 questions is different depending upon the type of question which it is, right? So again, your time management skills is very important. See, you should always know the test structure, what are the type of questions which you are going to come across, time management skills, how to see. There are two ways to solve any question. Any question you can solve in 2 minutes. There's another way where you can solve a particular question in 10 seconds also. So this is what is important. You should know the strategy and skill to solve that particular question in the minimum possible time, right? So that's what Edisha EduSupport, when we give you the training for your core test, we teach you how to solve any particular question in the minimum possible way, applying the strategies for that particular test, for that particular question. So there are four types of questions which with the sections which will come in the core test. The first one is solving quantitative problems. In this, again, 22 questions you will get, and you will get 45 minutes to solve these questions. Obviously maths quantitative problems means maths related questions are there. You are getting 45 minutes to solve 22 questions, but no calculator is allowed. No calculator. You will not get any on-screen calculator. You cannot take any physical calculator also. No, you have to solve mentally all these questions. So that means you should be very quick at solving these questions. Now these questions will be picked up from where? Since after high school you're taking up this test, so they will pick up the questions from your 8th standard till 12th standard math. Right, you will be having the questions related to numbers, integers, multiplication, division, subtraction, algebra, geometry, all these things the questions will be there. You'll have questions related to simple interest, you'll have compound interest, questions will be there, geometry will be there, and finding the area, square root, cube root, all these things will be, percentage related questions will also be there. But the most important thing is you should be able to solve these questions without calculator in minimum possible time, so that even if you have, like, no, I found students struggling with the questions and saying that, ma'am, even though I had 45 minutes, but I was not able to complete my 22 questions. So now remember one thing, there is no negative marking in your core test. So if you are running short of time, right, quickly mark, like guess some answer and then move ahead to the next topic, right? Now the next you will get inferring relationship. Now inferring relationship, you will get 22 questions again, but just 10 minutes to solve these questions. So again, this is testing you on your non-verbal ability, but something related to critical thinking skills and how your analytical skills, your logical thinking, this is what they are telling. So when I talk about critical thinking, logical thinking, analytical skills, you cannot take n number of time, right, to solve that particular question. So here 22 questions are there and just 10 minutes are there. That means not even 1 minute for one question is there, right? So not even 30 seconds per question, less than that, because there are 22 questions in just 10 minutes. So you have to be very quick in this. But again, over here also, the strategies and knowing the pattern will definitely help you to solve these questions in 10 minutes. Now, the third type is recognizing and continuing patterns. Now, again, it is related to your math, your number series, right? So, I'll give you some 8 square boxes will be there. In those 8 square box, you'll have patterns. You'll have the squares or hexagon, pentagon, circles, dots, straight lines, vertical lines, triangle, or a combination of all the figures. Now, in those 8 squares, 7 will be filled with these figures. And they will be following some pattern, right? Some will be shaded, some will be not shaded, somewhere will be a full dark black color will be there. So like where somewhere, so all that pattern will be there, and the 8th square, a question mark will be there. You'll get 4 options. Now out of those 4 options, you have to find out which option will be fitted for that particular question mark. Now here also, you need to think a lot. They are testing you again on your logical analytical skills. And you'll get 22 questions and just 20 minutes to solve this. So this is considered as the toughest part of your core test. When I spoke about inferring relations, there also students, they fall short of time and they are not able to complete the paper because the time is short. Again, when I talks about the recognizing and continuation of the pattern, time is short. And they are not able to solve that, right? Because they are not used to solving those type of the questions. Till 12th standard, I don't think so in any of the exams you have done this continuation of inferring patterns or relationship type of the questions. The last type of the questions is your continuing numerical series. Here you will get 22 questions and 25 minutes to solve this. So here this is the one. Part where you are getting 3 minutes extra, so you can spend little bit extra more than 1 minute in this part. So what you'll have series of numbers, and after that one question mark will be there. 7-8 numbers will be there, and the 8th number one question mark will be there. Now the relationship, you have to find out or identify the relationship between those numbers. They could be square root, division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. The relationship could be between the first and the fourth number, then fourth and the 8th number, or it could be first, third, then sixth, or it could be into first and second, third, like consecutive numbers also. So it could be 2 relationships series will be there. So again, you have to be very quick at your tables, addition, multiplication, division. No calculator is allowed over there. So your analytical skills, your critical thinking skills are something which are very important. That is what they are going to test you over there. As again, no calculator is allowed. Now the most important thing which I want to say is every section of this core test, students, they come back and they tell that, ma'am, we were not able to complete the questions in the given amount of the time. So I always say there's no negative marking. When you know that there's no negative marking, don't leave any question unanswered, right? So when you're running short of the time, quickly mark some answer and then move ahead to the next section. If you see, try to solve. If you feel that it's taking couple like little extra time for you, guess some answer and move ahead to the next question. And then later on, you can always come back and see whether if you can spare some extra time and solve it and put some other answer or correct your answer later on also. So this is what is about core test. Edisha EduSupport gives you the training in all these 4 sections of core test. We make you practice on these questions. I can say all the strategies we give you how the shortcuts, how to solve this, strategies, tips, and how to identify the question time, how to manage your time. Plus, for all these 4 types of questions which you come across in core test, each question type will make you practice more than 500 questions. And I'm pretty sure after you people nowadays, high school students are very smart. If you get a chance of solving 500 questions, right, related to a topic, and like every each if you make 100 mistakes, all 100 mistakes, I will sit with you and I'll tell you where you have gone wrong, what is the right way to solve that particular questions. So the perfect right guidance for test AS, you will get it at Edisha Edu Support. And we promise you, for each of these four topics, we will give you more than 500 questions, practice at home and in class, and we'll give you shortcuts how you can solve these questions. So I hope related to core test, all your doubts are solved now. And in my next video, I'll talk about subject specific test. Fine. Bye.